message here that an act can reach the heaven, the sky, because of the intention behind it, regardless of its size, how big or small it is. If the person is sincere, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make this act simply reach everywhere. And take, for example, قصه هذا الرجل, the story of this man who wanted to give a sadaqah in secret. حديث عند الإمام مسلم, حديث أبي هريرة. So he went and he placed the sadaqah in the hand of a prostitute. He didn't know. He wanted to do something between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the hands of a prostitute. Imagine he wanted to do this in secret. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewarded him that everybody in town actually spoke about his act, but made him sad because he assumed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not accept his act because it ended up in the hands of such a person. So he said, I'm going to try again. The following day, he ended up giving that sadaqah to a thief. Again, he didn't know. It's dark. He meets somebody in the street and he goes. Again, he wanted this to be in secret, right? But yet everybody in the morning started saying that the thief received what? A sadaqah. Now he assumed that maybe Allah did not accept my act. So I'm going to try one more time. So the third time he given it to who? Wealthy person. The wealthiest person in town. Imagine this. You know, he said he got upset and he thought, that's not good. I'm not a good person. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to him an angel. وَذَا بِيَحْدُثْ فِي بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ. This could happen in Bani Israel. Yani. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the messenger at the time to inform him this. يَا هَذَا, oh so and so, your sadaqah was accepted in the three occasions. Look at this now, because of the sincerity of this man, because of his niyyah. He's sincere about it. Who caused the corruption in the society to begin with? The rich person, because he was what? Stingy. This woman was prostituting because she needed money, and nobody would help her. No sadaqah. This thief was stealing because, of course, this is not a justification, but this the scenario here. Now that it's seeing you doing this in secret, guess what? He will start spending now. So imagine the sincerity of this man corrected what? The society. The society was corrected, reformed, the way that Allah what? يعني instructed them to be. فهذه النية يا إخوة. ويعني من ضمن هذه الأمور قالوا يعني at this our times now the governments back home like في السعودية and these places they arrest the scholars or in Egypt or they deprive them from giving lectures or teaching the crowd, the masses. Guess what? The time they were giving lectures before they stopped, they still receive the same reward. Because they can give lectures. If they let them give, they will give lectures. Imagine, he will be sitting in his house and he's getting the reward of giving a lecture in Dar al-Tawheed. Because he used to do that before what? What is my evidence for this? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was returning from Tabuk, he said to his companions who are returning with him, listen, there are people in Medina. Every move that you made, they receive the same exact reward like you. While they are in Medina. Huh? While they are what? In Medina. Why? Because of what? They wanted to be here, but they were prevented, they could not, because منعهم العذر. منعهم العذر. وقرأت يا إخوة, I don't know the name of the scholar, but he was arrested. So, and they would deprive them from praying, يعني observing Jum'ah in the jail. So every Jum'ah, right before Salatul Jum'ah, الأذان, he would put his clothes on and he would go out there to the guard. Guard, I want to go and pray Jum'ah. He said, no, you can't. So, Jazakallahu khaira. Then he takes it off and he goes back. Yeah, you don't have to do that, but he's emphasizing that I want to pray Jum'ah, but you prevented me. So it's new. And Allah will what? Is the intention behind it. Look, ya ikhwa, and this is what I want to discuss tonight, and inshallah we'll finish it tomorrow, so I don't keep you for long. Likewise, if you have an ill intention, you will be punished by getting the opposite. So you have a good intention, you receive what? Likewise, if you have a bad, ill intention in your heart, look, القاعدة تقول ماذا؟ المحتال بالباطل يعامل بنقيض قصده شرعا وقدرا. Someone who wanna trick Allah, who wanna do something that is haram and he has a bad intention, Allah will give him the opposite to what he intended in the Sharia and in the Qadr. قدرا. Let's take Qadr for example. Let's deal with Qadr. The brothers of Yusuf, when they wanted to get rid of Yusuf, what was their intention? Not to get rid of Yusuf. That was not the intention. What was the intention behind the act, getting rid of Yusuf? What? لا, هم قالوا, اقتلوا يوسف أو اطرحوه أرضا يخلو لكم وجه أبيكم. That's their intention. That's what they want. They want their father exclusively for what? For them, kill Yusuf or throw him someplace so that your father will be what? Yours. How did Allah punish them? زاد حب يعقوب ليوسف. The love that Yaqub had for Yusuf mounted. Increased to the extent that he lost what? At the end is قالوا تالله تفتأ تذكر يوسف حتى تكون حرضا أو يا رجل زهقنا من يوسف. يعني شوف, you keep talking about يوسف. هذا هو القدر. عقوبة, the punishment to the opposite of what? If the intention is bad, to the opposite of the intention. If the intention is bad, you get the opposite exactly, the contrary exactly. لذي يا إخوة, يعني سألوا المرأة العربية, يعني if these brothers are smart, they asked the Arab women, mother, من أحب أولادك إليك؟ Which of your children are the most beloved to you? You know what she said? الصغير حتى يكبر. The little one until what? He grows. والمريض حتى يشفى. And the sick until what? Cures. والغائب حتى يعود. And the absent until what? الإنسان بيتعلق بالغائب إذا كان محب. طب take for example another one. You want another example? أصحاب الجنة, the people of الجنة, why did they go in the middle of the night to harvest the Jannah, to harvest the garden? What was their intention? You know the story, right? سورة القلم, نون والقلم. إنا بلوناهم كما بلونا أصحاب الجنة إذ أقسموا ليصرمنها مصبحين ولا يستثنون. So they woke up in the middle of the night and they want to go and harvest their garden. What is the intention behind this act? Tell me, what was the intention?
ألا يدخلنها اليوم عليكم مسكين. They want to deprive the people, the مساكين, from their share. So that they have more what? What is their intention here? So they would have more what? More harvest, more fruits. What did Allah do to their Jannah, Isa? All of it is gone. So their intention is to what? To get more money. Right? Allah treated them with the opposite, with the contrary of their intention. Exactly. You want another example? The hadith أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عند البخاري: من أخذ أموال الناس ينوي سدادها سد الله عنه، ومن أخذ أموال الناس ينوي إتلافها أتلفه الله. When you go and borrow, let's say I'm going to go to Frank, for example, Frank, can you give me $1,000? When I take that money from you, يعني as a loan, I'm kidding, okay, I do not need any money, alhamdulillah. So while I'm taking it from Frank, my intention while he's handing me over the money, Ya Rab, help me, I pay him back, Ya Rab, Ya Rab. My intention is what? To pay it back. Allah will help you. Allah will help you. But when you're taking it, your intention is to be wealthier. Okay, I added $1,000 to my account. Forget about Frank. Allah will destroy all what? All the money. Another example? Huh? Let's go into, we said qadaran, so this is al-qadar here. What about al-shara'? Al-shari'a. Al-shari'a actually deal. If you are to inherit, look at the ruling. If you are to inherit somebody and you go and kill that person, guess what? You're deprived from the inheritance. Al-shara'a يقول لك كده. إذا ثبت قتلك له لا ترث. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث مسلم أحمد والترمذي: القاتل لا يورث. So if you want to kill, يعني if I'm inheriting and I go and so that like the story of البقرة, قصة البقرة, ما قصة البقرة هكذا, تعلمون قصة البقرة في سورة البقرة. If you go into the Israelites and if you who is to inherit his stingy uncle and his uncle is not sharing his wealth with him, and he said, you know what, let me just get rid of the guy and get the money instead of begging him, and he's not giving me any money. So the Sharia treated the person to the opposite. Likewise, if somebody wrote in his will that you get third of his inheritance, you could, ممكن أن توصي بالثلث ولا لا لغير الوارث, to someone who is entitled to your inheritance, to any of your inheritance. And you, okay, I wrote a third for you, Hilmi. And Hilmi comes and he gets rid of me, so what? So he can, Hilmi doesn't get it. There is another ruling which is very interesting. Someone while he is dying, الرجل وهو بيحتضر يا شيخ محمد على فراش موتي بيموت, and he want to punish his wife, he want to deprive her from the inheritance. يريد أن يحرمها من الميراث زوجته, فيطلقها ثلاثا طلاقا بائنا. Then he would divorce her three times irrevocable. يعني في رأيين في المسألة. In order what? What is his intention? لحرمانها من الإيه؟ من الإرث. To deprive her from the inheritance. ترث. الشريعة تقول لك ترث. إذا تبينت هذه ترث. There is an opinion, by the way, ما زالت في العدة. She will inherit as long as she's still into the 3-month عدة. There is another opinion, even after the عدة and he dies, she still inherits. There is another opinion that even if she goes and marries someone else, she's still entitled to the inheritance for this man. Because she didn't want to divorce. بغير رضاها. Huh? That's an example, right? Take, for example, someone who has money which is zakatable. He is to pay 2.5%, and the hawl, the annual hawl, you know that for you to be eligible for zakah, you have to own a minimum amount and more, and it must be owned by what? Owned for what? For 1 year. Now, right before the year hits, you go and what? You decrease the nisab. You make that wealth unzakatable, doesn't qualify because it's lesser than what? 75 grams of gold, 85, I'm sorry, grams of gold, or 555 grams of, 95 grams of silver. You're getting the point? You're tricking Allah. You're tricking Allah. The ruling that this person has to pay the zakat, even though his money is not there. وشوف يا إخوة سبحان الله يعني أنا أقول لك شيء in closing it. We'll add more to this tomorrow إن شاء الله. بني إسرائيل قتلوا الأنبياء فعلوا يعني they did all type of things. But the one thing that Allah سبحانه وتعالى did not like from them at all was what? Tricking Allah. When he said to them, don't fish on Saturday, and what did they end up doing? Allah turned them into what? Apes. Because it's a sign, if you think that you can trick Allah, that's a sign that you don't know who Allah is. You don't know who Allah is. Or the greatness of Allah is not present in the heart. That you can go and do a business transaction or do something that can you trick the Sharia with it. No, it doesn't go this way. Inshallah, we'll continue this tomorrow. بإذن الله تعالى. جزاكم الله خيرا. Good to see you again. I miss you. I was in Canada and San Diego, 10 days tour. And alhamdulillah, you know, sharing the knowledge with a lot of people. Alhamdulillah, make dua. We'll continue tomorrow, inshallah. Subhanak Allahumma wa hamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Alhamdulillah.